Dear student, I welcome you for the today's lecture related to the resistances, thermal resistances and the heat transfer through the composite wall. Now, in general, according to the Fourier law of heat conduction, Q which is equal to minus Ka dT upon dx. On integration from limit x equals to 0, that is at a distance x equals to 0, to the distance x equals to L, and from temperature T1 to T2, on integration you will get Q which is equal to Ka T1 minus T2 upon L. This is the rate of heat conduction through the plane wall is proportional to the average thermal conductivity K, the wall area A and the temperature difference delta T, but is inversely proportional to the wall thickness. Once the rate of heat conduction is available, the temperature Tx at any location x that can be determined by replacing the T2 by a certain temperature T, which is to be calculated, and L by X. So that is to be equated and is to be calculated. Now we will consider the concept of thermal resistance. So this is our heat conduction equation. Now if I will write this L upon Ka, this is a resistance, a wall resistance. That is Q heat transfer by the conduction through the wall. Heat transfer by the conduction through the wall. So that is the temperature difference across the wall upon the thermal resistance offered by the wall. So L upon Ka, that becomes equals to my wall resistance. So the conduction resistance, so it is called the conduction resistance of the wall, R wall, that is the conduction resistance of the wall, L upon Ka, that is called the thermal resistance of the wall against heat conduction. Now I can write this T1 to T2, and in between that there is a resistance R, and which is having a value of L upon Ka. So heat transfer from this temperature T1 to T2, that is calculated as Q which is equal to T1 minus T2 upon the R. This is related to the thermal resistance. Now also we have studied in the first year, that is related to the electrical resistances. So electrical resistances I, that is the electric current, which is equal to the voltage difference upon the electrical resistance, where electrical resistance Re, that is equal to L upon sigma E into the A. Now this is the analogy between the thermal and the electrical resistance concept. What is that? So for electrical resistance also I can write the V1 to V2, that is the potential difference, voltage difference. That is why the electric current flows, is because of the difference. All technologies and all subjects are there because of this difference. Because of the temperature difference, electrical engineering is because of the voltage difference, mass transfer is because of the concentration difference, fluid is because of the pressure difference. Pressure difference hai, isliye liquid flow hota hai. That is to be remembered. Heat flows is because of the temperature difference. Concentration flows, material flows is because of the concentration difference. Similarly, this electric current flows is because of the voltage difference. So the rate of heat transfer that corresponds to the electric current. Then this Q that corresponds to the I, rate of heat transfer Q that corresponds to the electric current I. Then the thermal resistance, that is the R, corresponds to the electrical resistance RE. And the difference, because why the heat transfer takes place, is because of the temperature difference that corresponds to the voltage difference, that is why the current that flows. So this is the electrical analogy between the thermal and the electrical resistance concepts. That is one aspect. You can write this in terms of the electrical resistances. Now, the Newton's law of cooling, you must have heard that it corresponds to the Q, which is equal to HA into delta T. HA into delta T. Where H is the heat transfer coefficient. H is the heat transfer coefficient. And TS minus T infinity. Now look at this figure. This is the solid wall that is there. And TS is the surface temperature. And T infinity is the surrounding temperature. Now, there is a surface wall that is available. This is heated at a surface temperature TS. And around surrounding, that's the uniform air temperature that is there. Say, my hand is having, say, 35 degrees Celsius temperature. And in the surrounding air, that is, say, around 23 degrees Celsius. Now, at present, it can be. So, from 35 degrees Celsius to the surrounding temperature of 23 degrees Celsius, there is a heat that will transfer. However, there is a certain air film that will exist, which is going to prevent the direct loss of heat from my hand to the atmosphere. That is what? It's a film resistance that can be considered. A film resistance that can be considered. An air film which is adhering to my hand. So that is the H is the heat transfer coefficient is because of this film. Now, similarly, you can say that in a pipe, when the liquid that flows, the fluid which is adhered to the wall, surface wall, that is having the zero velocity. We have studied the velocity profile. It is like a parabolic velocity profile. So, at the surface, the velocity is zero. That is what we are taking into account. A certain liquid film exists just on the wall surface. So similarly here on the metal plate, a certain air film that will exist, and this air film acts as a resistance for the heat flow, and this is the nothing but the H, the convective heat transfer coefficient. This is H is the convective heat transfer coefficient, that is also called the convection resistance. Now this TS into the T infinity, that is the T infinity is nothing but the surrounding temperature. TS is the surface temperature. So from surface temperature, which is a higher temperature, it goes to the surrounding temperature, and R convective, which is defined as 1 upon HAS. 1 upon HAS. H is the convective heat transfer coefficient. So this is called the convection resistance of the surface. It is on the surface. It is on this metal surface. Isliye isko convective resistance of the surface kaha gaya hai. Because this metal plate, uska jo kuch surface rahega, us surface pe liquid film aayegi, and that is what it एयर फिल्म आएगी एंड विच इज ऑफरिंग दिस रेजिस्टेंस, दैट इज व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड द कन्वेक्टिव रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ द सरफेस। सरफेस के कारण वो रेजिस्टेंस आपको मिल रहा है। दिस थर्मल रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ द सरफेस अगेंस्ट द हीट कन्वेक्शन। सो दिस इज व्हाट कैन बी ड्रॉन, दैट इज टी एस एंड टी इंफिनिटी क्यू विच इज फ्लोइंग एज and is calculated as HA into the TS minus T infinity. So when the convective heat transfer coefficient is very large, H tends to infinity, the convection resistance becomes zero. When H tends to infinity, that means heat transfer coefficient is very large. Heat transfer coefficient H is very large. That is H tending to infinity, this convection resistance becomes zero. This value of H is higher, so R value that becomes the lower. So this value, lower value, that means the Q that is almost corresponding to this temperature difference. That is, the surface offers no resistance to the convection and thus it does not slow down the heat transfer process. When the heat transfer coefficient H is very large, that means it tends to infinity. That means it tends to infinity means it doesn't have the very high value in more than 10,000 or so. So its value is around only hundreds and thousand, not more than that. This situation is approached in practice at the surfaces where the boiling and condensation occurs. The process of boiling and condensation, the convective heat transfer coefficient value of H is around 5000 to 10,000. That depends on the surface. So, the process of boiling and condensation, this H that can be neglected. However, for other situations, this H that can be taken into account. If it is given into a certain problem, then you have to take into account, or else you can neglect it also. Now, the combining the convective and the wall resistance and again the convective resistance. So, the rate of heat convection into the wall, that is the rate of heat convection into the wall, which is equal to the rate of heat conduction through the wall, means through the wall the heat is getting heat is transferred because of the conduction, and from atmosphere the heat is transferred to this wall, that is because of the convection. Similarly, the rate of heat convection from the wall to the wall and from the wall. So there can be taken into account T infinity to the T1, then to the T2, and then T infinity 2. That is what one can write. So first resistance, that is in between T infinity to the T1. T infinity to the T1, then second resistance that is going to reduce the temperature from T1 to T2, from T1 to T2, and the third resistance, again R convection, that is T2 to the T infinity 2. So one has to take into account the three resistances in this case. Now in the previous cases, we have talked for the first resistance, that is from T1 to T2, that is from T1 to T2, this is in a metal wall. Then this second resistance, that is because of the convection on one side, and in this figure we are considering the convection on one side of the wall and convection on the another side of the wall, and this is the third metal wall resistance. So three resistors that come into the picture. Now one by one we will write the individual equation for that. That is what? The rate of heat convection into the wall. Q, the rate of heat transfer. The rate of heat convection into the wall, which is same as the rate of heat conduction through the wall, and which is equal to the rate of heat convection from the wall. So all these three equations that can be equated. Q, the rate of heat transfer, that is from T infinity to the T1, that is T infinity to T1. Here it is because of the convection. And what is the formula for convection? That is HA into delta T. Now delta T, which delta T I have to take into account here? From T infinity 1 to the T1. This is what the temperature difference that is there. So I can write T infinity 1 minus T1 upon H1A. Here the H1A, that is to be taken into account when the rate of heat convection into the wall we are taking, that is H1. Then the through the wall, that is the temperature difference T1 to T2, higher temperature minus lower temperature, upon length upon Ka, that is what is coming from here, this equation. That is Ka T1 minus T2 upon L, the same formula, that is T1 minus T2 upon the R resistance, where L upon Ka is the R wall. The same formula that is to be used. T1 to T2, T1 to T2 temperature difference, from higher temperature to the lower temperature difference, and the distance upon Ka, L upon Ka. This is equals to the rate of heat convection from the wall. That is T2 minus rate of heat convection from the wall, that is equal to T2 minus T infinity to T2. T2 minus T infinity 2. That is 1 upon H2A. So I can write this T infinity 1 minus T1, which is upon R convection 1, which is equal to T1 minus T2 upon the R resistance because of the wall, which is equal to T2 minus T infinity 2 upon the resistance because of the convection 2. So total, when I want to calculate by adding all these resistances, I can write this equation Q, which is equal to T1 infinity, T infinity 1 minus T infinity 2, and the summation of the R convection 1, resistance because of the wall, and the resistance because of the convection 2. This can be written as a overall temperature difference. That means in between these two temperatures, there are three resistances we are assuming. That is, one is because of the convection, second because of the metal wall, and third is because of the convection of the film. So these three, four temperatures, T infinity 1, T1, T2 and T infinity 2, that accounts for one resistance, second resistance, and the third resistance. So this is the overall equation I can write. So R total, that is the total resistance, which is equal to R convection 1 plus the resistance because of the wall plus the second convective resistance, and they are equal to 1 upon H1A plus L upon Ka plus 1 upon H2 A. So this is a single wall we have considered here. Now we will consider the two walls. We have added one wall. So T infinity 1, temperature T1. First wall or the interface temperature is the T2. And at the end of second wall, its temperature is T3. And it goes to the T infinity 2. The thermal conductivities are K1, K2. Here the H1 is the heat transfer coefficient on one side, on the one side. And H2 is the heat transfer coefficient on the another side. So Q that is flowing through it. So the overall heat transfer coefficient, heat transfer that can be equals to T infinity 1 minus T infinity 2. T infinity 1 minus T infinity 2. Here I have to take into account the first resistance is because of the convection. The second resistance is because of the first wall. The third resistance that is because of the second wall. And the fourth resistance because of the convection too. So I can write this R total from T infinity 1 minus T infinity 2. But this R total that incorporates the four resistances, that is R because of the convection 1, R because of the wall 1, R because of the wall 2, and R because of the convection 2. So for R convection 1 upon H1A, R wall that is nothing but the conduction is because of the conduction L upon K1A, R because of the wall 2, L2. L2 is the thickness and K2 is the thermal conductivity of the second wall. And in this case, the surface area are same for the wall 1 and wall 2. So this is for the two layers. The thermal resistance network for the heat transfer through a two-layer plane wall subjected to the convection on both sides. This is the convection on both the sides we have taken into account. So it is not necessary that always the temperatures are in a straight line. The temperature can vary slightly, and then a drastic drop in this, that again depends on your thermal conductivities and the thickness of the wall. Now this can be extended to the three walls also. So in this figure, this is the three walls. Here the temperature notations are different. Instead of T infinity 1, it becomes TA. Instead of T infinity 2, it becomes TB. Temperature 1 T1, temperature 2 T2, temperature 3 T3, and temperature 4 T4. Thermal conductivity is K1, K2, K3. The thicknesses are L1, L2, L3. So the heat transfer that will be equals to the AHA into TA minus T1. Q, which is equal to A, the surface area, TA minus T1 is because of the convection. Then because of the conduction, the same conduction formula. That means till now we have talked related to the three different formulas. Q, which is equal to MCP delta T, that we are already knowing. Q, which is equal to KA dT upon dx. That is because of the conduction, that is the Fourier law. And third, that is because of the Newton's law of convection. That is Q which is equal to HA delta T. Now here we are using Q is equal to HA delta T and Q which is equal to KA delta T upon dx. Then from the second wall, K2 A into bracket T3 minus T2 upon L2, here negative sign, that is given. So the difference is higher temperature to lower temperature difference, then there is no negative sign. So I can combine all the five resistances in this case. That is Q, which is equal to 1 upon HA into A plus L1 upon AK1, L2 upon AK2 plus L3 upon AK3 plus 1 upon HBA. That is what? The summation of resistances that is coming into the picture. That is the total temperature gradient T infinity 1 minus T infinity 2 upon the total resistances. You can see here TA minus TB, which is nothing but TA minus T1 plus T1 minus T2 plus T2 minus T3 plus T3 minus T4 plus T4 minus TB. So overall that will be equals to TA minus TB, and that is what we are writing it for the here TA minus TB, and we are adding all the summation resistances that will be added. That is what? The 1 upon UA, and U is called the overall heat transfer coefficient. U is the overall heat transfer coefficient. H is the individual heat transfer coefficient. This HA, that is the individual heat transfer coefficient. This is HB, that is also the individual heat transfer coefficient. This is on one side of the wall. This is on the second side of the wall. Now, overall, we can define it as the heat flow, heat transfer, or the heat flow, that is equal to the thermal potential difference. That is what? The maximum temperature gradient, TA minus TB, that is the thermal potential difference upon the thermal resistances. Jitne sare resistances hai, us process mein ke, they can be added. Which is similar to the Ohm's law in electrical circuit theory. Then this was the plates arranged in parallel. Ek ke baad mein ek plates, they are arranged. One, the next, the next. Now the second situation, that is the heat transfer by convection on the two sides of a composite wall is absent. The figure is like this. Now the figure changed. So how to draw this resistances in this case? Overall temperature, that is TA, and TB. So overall temperature here I can write TA and the TB. Now in between that, the T1 is the surface temperature, T2 is this surface temperature, T3 is this surface temperature, and T4 is this surface temperature. Then I have written T1, T2, T3, and T4, and TB. Right, here they are. T1, T2, T3, and T4. So for this metal wall, all these are the different A and B, that is the two plates, can be having the different thermal conductivities, but the width in this case, they are taken as the same. Materials are different, that means the thermal conductivities are different. So resistance RA is because of this metal A. Resistance RB, that is because of this resistance B. Then similarly RD, RE, and RF, D, E, and F, that is because of these resistances. And there is a single metal piece, that is C. So only one resistance that has been taken into account. So this is the series and parallel wall. So you can write the summation of the resistances, that is equal to summation of R, which is equal to RA, because of the convection. This is because of the metal A and B. This is because of the metal C, resistance because of the metal C. And this is the third layer, that is the resistances because of the metal D, E and F. And finally, the convective resistance on the another side. So this is called the U overall heat transfer coefficient into the surface area A that is to be taken into account. That is what I can write Q, which is equal to TA minus TB upon the summation of the resistances. Now we will solve the problems based on this. That is, the wall of 0.5 meter thickness, this wall that is of a 0.5 meter thickness, is to be constructed from a material which has the average thermal conductivity of 1.4 watt per meter Kelvin. Right? The wall is to be insulated, then it has to be provided with a certain insulation with a material having an average thermal conductivity of 0.35. This wall is having the thermal average thermal conductivity of 3.35 watt per meter Kelvin. So that the heat losses per meter square, per square meter, will not exceed 1450 watt. That means the heat through this is not, heat flow through this metal wall, through this composite wall, will not exceed 1450 watts. That is what the limitation is. Now in this case, the thickness of this insulation that is not provided, assuming that the inner and the outer surfaces of 1200 degrees Celsius and the 15 degrees Celsius, they are there. That means this is related to the furnace. So this is the furnace that is available here, and this furnace temperature that is exposed to the 1200 degrees Celsius, and this is the surrounding temperature of say 15 degrees Celsius. So we can consider the two resistances in this case, that is the resistance because of this first metal having the thermal conductivity K1 and the resistance because of the second metal having the thermal conductivity K1 and K2. So temperature difference T1 to T2 upon the individual resistances, that is return. Then substituting the value of Q, which is the maximum heat transfer that is permitted. The heat loss per meter square will not exceed 1450 watts. That is what our limitation is. And accordingly, we have to calculate this thickness L2. Thickness L2 that is to be calculated for this purpose. So, 1450 into the temperature difference, maximum and the minimum. This is the 0.5 is the wall thickness L upon the thermal conductivity K. Similarly, here the L2 upon the thermal conductivity of the second material. This 1450 that is having the units of watt, and you have to calculate the heat loss per square meter. That is what is expected. So we are assuming the area as 1 meter square. Area that is considered to be as the 1 meter square. So L2 that is calculated as 0.161 meter. So this will be the thickness L2, that is 0.161, insulation that thickness, that is 0.16 meter, that will be provided. Now coming to the next problem. This is the furnace problem we have dealt with. Now we are coming to the cold storage problem. That is the, say, refrigerators. The door of a cold storage plant is made from 2 6 millimeter thick glass sheets. This is one glass sheet. This is another glass sheet, separated by a uniform air gap. Here the air gap that is mentioned of 2 millimeter thickness. The temperature of the air inside the room is minus 20 degrees Celsius, temperature of the air, that is minus 20 degrees Celsius, and the ambient air temperature is 30 degrees Celsius. Assuming the heat transfer coefficient between the glass and the air to be 23.26 watt per meter square Kelvin. Heat transfer coefficient between the glass and air, between this glass and the air. Determine the rate of heat leaking into the room per unit area of the door. That means how much amount of the heat. Higher temperature is 30 degrees Celsius, minus 20 degrees Celsius. That means heat will flow from higher temperature to the lower temperature in this direction. Neglect the convection effects in the air gap. In this air gap, one can neglect the convection effects. However, at the wall, at the outer wall, the convection effects that can be taken into account. These convection effects, assuming the heat transfer coefficient between the glass and the air is 23.26 watt per meter square Kelvin. That means on this side 23.26 watt per meter square Kelvin. On this side also the 23.26 watt per meter square Kelvin. But we are neglecting this convection effect in this air gap. So the total resistances. The first resistance is because of this convection, that is 1 upon HA. Then the metal wall, L1 upon K1, then L2 upon K2 is because of the air film, then next is because of the metal wall again, L3 upon K3, and because of the air film outside the glass, that is H1B. So the temperature differences that is to be taken into account, TA minus TB, overall temperature difference, this is Q upon A. So total temperature differences, 1 upon HA is 23.26, 1 upon HB, that is nothing but 23.26. The thicknesses of the glass wall, that is 0.006. And another glass wall, that is also 0.006. The thermal conductivity of the glass, that is 0.075. So similarly, the other case 0.075 also. And this is because of the air film. Thermal conductivity of the air 0.02. Thermal conductivity of the air, that is 0.02. And the thermal conductivity of glass, that is 0.75. So Q upon A, that comes as 247.5 watt per meter square. That is the overall heat transfer per unit area we have calculated. Now the next problem that is also there, but this is with a different metals. That is first metal. Then metal, it's a combination of parallel and series metal that is available. Sorry. And B metal is here and C metal is here. These are in parallel and these two are in series. So determine the heat transfer through the composite wall as shown in this figure. Take the conductivities of A, B, C, D, metal A, B, C, D and E as mentioned here respectively, and assume one dimensional heat transfer. We are assuming one dimensional heat transfer from higher temperature, because it's a 800 degree Celsius temperature, and here T2, that is 100 degree Celsius. So heat will transfer from higher temperature to the lower temperature respectively, and assuming the one dimensional heat transfer. So RA, that is the total resistances, which is into the KA. This is the 50 is the thermal conductivity, and A is the 1 meter square area that is taken into account, and the thickness L, that is, this is 5 centimeter. So it becomes your 0.05 meters. So that comes as the 1 into 10 to the power minus 3 watt per meter Kelvin. Then similarly, I have to calculate it for the second, third and fourth. How to calculate it for the second? Then RB is 0.1 L upon K into the A. Area is 0.5, area for C, that is also 0.5. So this area, that is divided as 0.5 and 0.5. Ye surface area 0.5 hai, ye surface area 0.5 hai. So that is what the 0.1 upon 10, 10 is the thermal conductivity for the material B. And for the material C, that is 6.67. For the material C, that is 6.67. So we have calculated RB and RC. Similarly, RD and RE, L upon KA. L is the 0.05 thermal conductivity for the material D. The thickness for the material E, thermal conductivity for the material E. So we have calculated all the resistances. Then we can do the summation for that. So the equivalent resistance, that will be calculated as RB and RF, that is the first we have calculated it for the RB and RC, which is in the series. So 1 upon RF, that is resultant resistance because of the RB and RC. So that comes as the thing, and total summation of the resistances, that incorporates RA, RF. This RF incorporates the resistances because of the RB and RC, and this is RD and RE. So one can add all these resistances and finally calculate the Q, heat transfer coefficient, incorporating the overall temperature difference T1 to T2. So that comes as the 40.7 kilowatt